In this problem, we are asked to solve the absolute value inequality 2 times the absolute value of x minus 5 plus 6 is greater than 14. In order to solve this inequality, one thing that we could do is isolate that absolute value. Therefore, I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides of the inequality. This gives me 2 times the absolute value of x minus 5 is greater than 14 minus 6, or 8. Since I have 2 times the absolute value of x minus 5, and I want to isolate that absolute value sign, I'm going to divide both sides of my inequality by 2. I notice that 2 divided by 2 cancels to make 1. Therefore, I have the absolute value of x minus 5 is greater than 4. Now, let's take a moment to remember the definition of the absolute value. One way that we can visualize this is on a number line centered at 0. The absolute value then represents the distance away from 0. That is, in this case, we want to find a number such that we subtract 5, and the absolute value of that is going to be greater than 4. This will happen in 2 cases. Either x minus 5 is greater than 4, or that quantity x minus 5 is going to be less than a negative 4. Now I have 2 linear inequalities and I can solve for each one of them. If I solve x minus 5 is less than negative 4 by adding 5 to both sides, I result in the inequality that x has to be less than 1. So any number less than 1 would satisfy our absolute value inequality. Or, solving the second inequality, x minus 5 is greater than 4, by adding 5 to both sides, I get x is greater than 9. Therefore, any value greater than 9, when substituted back into our absolute value inequality, would produce a true statement. Let's check this. For example, if I plug in x equal to 0 into my original inequality, I would have 2 times the absolute value of 0 minus 5 plus 6, and I want to check to see if that is indeed greater than 14. Well, let's see. 0 minus 5 is a negative 5, and the absolute value of a negative 5 is a positive 5. So I have 2 times 5 plus 6. Well, 2 times 5 is 10, plus 6 more is 16. Therefore, I know that 16 is indeed greater than 14. Let's try a number that's greater than 9 to make sure that we have the correct solution. For example, if I say x is equal to 10, when x is equal to 10, I can substitute that back into my original inequality to get 2 times the absolute value of 10 minus 5, plus 6, and I want to know if this is greater than 14. 10 minus 5 is 5, and the absolute value of 5 is also 5, so I have 2 times 5 plus 6. Now I can see that 2 times 5 is 10, plus 6 more is 16, and 16 is indeed greater than 14. Therefore, I know that I have a solution set of either x is less than 1 or x is greater than 9. If I wanted to write this in interval notation, I would write each one separately. For example, x is less than 1 can be written in interval notation as any number less than 1. Therefore, I would have negative infinity all the way up to but not including 1. Or x is greater than 9 would tell me that I would take all the numbers greater than 9. Since I'm not including 9, I'll draw the parentheses. So this would be 9 to infinity.